So we're about to head to downtown Chicago to visit the presidential Twitter library established by Trevor Noah and The Daily Show. So this is going to be interesting. We'll see what ends up happening. I will be meeting Victor downtown, and I have a feeling he's going to get a kick out of this. It should be interesting. But it's a beautiful day. I think this should be fun.
I think we're going the wrong way.
That is a crazy line.
Totally worth it. You know, me what? Leaving to get some beers, coming back.
Even more worth it.
Yeah.
All right. So it's the end of the day, we're on the train, getting ready to head home. Victor's playing with his hair right now, I'm waiting for it to finish.
We waited in line for 1 hour. First of all, we walk into Union Station from the entrance on Madison, we just go down as if we're taking a train, and we're fucking walking like what felt like several minutes to get to the other side of the train station we walk in. I've never been to Union Station. So immediately as we're walking in and around, I'm just like, wow, this station is beautiful. Very classic, very elegant. We walk into the exhibit, watch a video, just see all this stuff. It was very well done. The Daily Show did a great job putting together this exhibit of Donald Trump's tweets for the presidential library. It was cool, I had a fun time.
I was genuinely surprised with how they mobilize this amount of technology for 2 days. This museum is only open for 2 days, and they basically redid an entire section of Union Station, set up columns and pillars and stuff like that. These triangular pillars with Trump's tweets on them. What I was surprised about the most was the number of people who left with smiles on their faces.
Yes,
that
agreed.
Was probably the biggest surprise out of this whole thing, because you're going into a situation where it's like you have to confront this dude is the president of the United States. But I think everyone came in with a similar attitude of just being very casual about it, being like, this is lighthearted, this is supposed to be fun, this is kind of a joking thing. And so everyone we saw while we were waiting in line for an hour was coming out with just these smiles on their faces, laughing and joking and all that. And as we were leaving, these two girls, who had also been waiting in line for an hour and were just about to get in, stopped us and were like, they told us, we're on the borderline.
They had just hit one hour.
And they were looking at us like for some sort of reassurance, please tell us it was worth it. Like, was it worth it? Was it enjoyable? And we were able to respond with certainty.
What was your favorite piece of the exhibit or favorite tweet that you saw, or just anything that stood out to you that you really enjoyed?
I'd have to say it was the golden toilet. The toilet.
Oh, thing. Interesting.
That was very interactive. Now, I mean, I'll definitely have to ask Victor what the experience is like, but being down there, I was looking at you, I'm like, dude, I mean, you could totally be president. You have all the qualifications.
One of my favorite things was when we heard we saw the red flashing light and the beeping noise or whatever it was.
And they announced
a live tweet from the president, a live tweet from the president. What? And everyone just kind of went to this corner, and you sure enough, you see the tweet sent 57 seconds ago. I also really liked that they had a table with maybe like 8 golden plaques of tweets that were deleted but not forgotten. It said tweets deleted but not forgotten, 8 golden plaques, and then they had roses all around it of just tweets that he had obviously tweeted and then deleted. And that was pretty interesting too. The whole thing was fun.
The whole thing was a lot of fun.
It was definitely worth waiting an hour in line to get into. It was free. And how long would you say that we spent there?
We were in there for over a half an hour.
I was gonna say for at least 45 minutes.
I think we were there for about 45 minutes. Yeah. I mean, just soaking in everything that we experienced.
I was talking with one of the guys who was running the things, and I was just like, where are you from? And he said, well, we're from all over the place. And like, well, are you from Chicago or New York? You know, are you a staffer on The Daily Show or whatever? Turns out all those people who were there worked for Comedy Central. And so Comedy Central brought them in from all over the country, from LA, from Chicago, from New York, from Atlanta. And they basically do Comedy Central events. So anytime that they have some sort of, they have stand-up comedians do specials and things like that. So they're the people who generally do logistics. And he was just saying how cool of a opportunity this was for them to bring the tweet library to Chicago on the same week that Trevor Noah was in town to film this show. It was, I mean, just the coordination. And the fact that everyone who was working there, too, seemed like they were having a good time. I couldn't imagine how many hours they had been there already, but they seemed to be in good spirits, right? And
yes.
It seemed like that had to do a lot with the attitude of everyone who was there. So I really appreciate that part.